All right, in this video, we're just going to do a quick, you know, shooting from the hip go over of the different types of items that you can set up in QuickBooks. And then we have different videos just to go more in depth into each item type. But I'm just going to start out by going here to the items list. And I'm going to go down to the drop down here and select new item. This gives me the choice of all the drop downs of different items that you have. Okay. So the first item is a service item. This is for any consulting, labor, anything that you do for a client that is not giving them a physical product. So it can be things like printing, it can be contracted services, it can be babysitting, it can be any kind of service that you offer. All right. Then you have an inventory part. Inventory parts are goods that you purchase and hold in your inventory. So you hold it as an asset to your business until it's sold off. Different from a fixed asset in that it's not, you purchase it and it stays with the business, like a desk, right? You purchase it, it stays with the business. Okay. An inventory part is something that you purchase. When you purchase it, it raises the value of your business. And then when you sell it, it lowers the value of your business, but ups your sales. Okay. We have an inventory assembly. All right. With an inventory assembly, the way to think about this, a lot of people get confused between assembly and a group. You know, what's the difference there? An assembly is you have part A, you have part B, you have part C. Okay. And then when you melt them all together or build them together, you get part A, B, C. So part A, part B, part C, one of each gets merged together. So now you have one less quantity of A, part A, part B, and part C, but one plus quantity of part A, B, C. Okay. Using assemblies, only use them if you actually do part A, B, C, and then also possibly sell individually A, B, and C, or purchase them individually, A, B, and C. Otherwise, if you're just dealing with A, B, C, like bicycles, for example, you don't need to put every bicycle part in there unless you purchase the bicycle parts individually or sell them individually. Otherwise, it's just a bicycle. Okay? So non-inventory parts, these are things that you purchase and sell, but you don't necessarily hold them on hand. So for people who buy from distribution, then they buy it from distribution and say distribution drop ships it to the end user. They never have it on their premises. It's never part of their assets. It just goes straight from their vendor to their customer. So we consider it a non-inventory part. Same with some miscellaneous kind of materials. Instead, when you purchase a non-inventory part, instead of going into assets like the inventory part would, the non-inventory part just gets straight expensed out. Okay, so those are for small items that you're not really tracking. Screws, nails, you know, small little things that you're not really tracking in your inventory. All right. Then we have an other charge here. Other charges are things like trip charges, handling, shipping, you know, random charges that get added to a bill that are not, again, a service charge, but something a little bit more, you know, generic, you know, delivery, setup, all that fun stuff. Then we have a subtotal item. These are used to create a subtotal on an invoice. So essentially what it'll do is you put that line in there, it will total up all the lines above it, and then it'll allow you to do a discount for all the lines above it because it you know, does a discount off of the subtotal. But basically it'll allow you to create a subtotal on an invoice, a subtotal line. It's not needed unless you're wanting to give some kind of total, you know, discount or add something to or separate out, because the subtotal will also be shown on the bottom of the invoice if you don't need it, you know, and we'll go into that more in the video. But it basically just creates a line for you to total everything above it. Now we have a group item, which again, assembly, inventory assembly and groups are a little bit different. In inventory assembly, part A, part B, and part C get melted together. In groups, what it is that we have part A, part B, and part C, and they're frequently sold together, but they're not really built together. So maybe we sell, you know, let's say A, B, and C are actually three different books. And so frequently, the books get sold as a trilogy, but not always. So we have the group there, you know, so that whenever somebody comes in and buys the trilogy, we can quickly enter it on the invoice because we have a group called, you know, Trilogy of ABC. And so it can quickly be entered on the invoice. You don't have to go in and put on item A, item B, item C. Okay. The other difference is when you have a group item, the parts don't come out of quantities. The quantities don't come out of A, B, and C until it shows up on an invoice. Whereas with an inventory assembly, you have part A, part B, and part C. You do a build. It takes away from part A, part B, and part C and adds quantity of one to part A, B, C. Okay. Confusing, I know. But again, we go into those in the other videos if you want to look at them in more depth. You have discount items. This allows you to have a discount. Things that I've seen people use is like online discount, online purchase discount, customer loyalty discount, you know, damage discount, things like that. The reason to have different discounts is so that you can run a report to see which discounts you're giving away the most money with. And then also you can use them for like promotion codes. So if you do a marketing campaign and you want to track the marketing campaign to see how much business it drove to your, or, you know, how many people came into your business because of this marketing campaign, you can use a promo code or a discount code that you track in here to see how much, what's the quantity or how many new customers came in based on this discount, because I can run a quick report on it. Okay, you do have a payment in here. So if somebody makes a partial payment or a payment up front on an invoice, you can use this payment feature here. And, you know, it'll go into undeposited funds. And then, so let's say you have a $1,000 invoice, they make a $500 payment. The $500 would go into undeposited funds and you'd still have $500 sitting in accounts receivable waiting for their second payment. I don't always use these. Take a look at my customer deposits video and just see, determine which is best for your business. Okay. Sales tax item. This is the individual item on a sales tax, meaning if you live in a wonderful state where you have sales tax by county, city, jurisdiction, whatever, all the different levels of sales tax that you can have, this item will be, you know, city, state. Let's just pretend Austin. You have Austin city tax. I've got the state tax and I've got a jurisdiction tax. Okay, so I'd have three different sales tax items. But then on the invoice, I would build a group called Austin sales tax, which would have in it all three of those items. So it would still break out for me in my reports who I need to pay what percentage of tax to, but it just shows it to the end user as one giant group, Austin tax. All right, so that's just a quick run through of all the different items that you can have, item types you can have. And again, if you want more information, check out the other videos where we go more in depth in each individual type.